After the tragic events in Charlottesville recently, many are very concerned about tension and hatred in the country. And a long revered figure in Virginia history is at the center of that controversy, whose name appears on one military installation, one university, and five public schools in the Commonwealth. So today we begin to ask the critical question, who was Robert E. Lee? Did you know that Robert E. Lee was a graduate of the United States Military Academy at West Point? Maybe you did, but did you know that he went there because, despite being a descendant of one of the first families of Virginia, Robert E. Lee had no wealth, no land, and no slaves, and wanted to secure a position in a profession where he could serve with honor and achieve some stature. And at West Point, Lee did not study to become a tactician, but rather engaged in study of very practical disciplines as one of the early STEM graduates in engineering. Did you know that Robert E. Lee retired as a lieutenant general with 3 stars from the Army of Northern Virginia? Maybe you did, but did you know that before resigning his commission with the Union, where he had fought Santa Anna and distinguished himself as the most incredible soldier that General Winfield Scott ever saw, in Mexico, and helped to capture John Brown at Harper's Ferry, he had served for over 30 years, but was only a colonel when both Lincoln and Davis asked him to lead their armies into battle. Did you know that Lee's Army of Northern Virginia was essentially a state militia that took responsibility for the entire Eastern effort of the war for the Confederate States of America? And did you know that Lee sustained an army in the field for almost 5 years that was under-equipped and facing a formidable foe that engaged in a reckless prosecution of battle to scorch the earth, punish the South, and accept casualties and battle losses on an unprecedented scale? Did you know that before the war, Robert E. Lee was a resident of Arlington, Virginia? Maybe you did, but did you know that his house, plantation, and slaves, over 70 in all, were the properties of the Custis House that was inherited by his wife, a descendant of George Washington, in 1857 from her father, just 3 years before the war? Did you know that as a soldier, that was only Lee's family home, and that he spent much of his time in what we might call deployments in the modern day, like his participation in the Harper's Ferry raid that captured John Brown in 1859? Did you know that as a resident of Arlington, Robert E. Lee attended the Christ Church in Old Town Alexandria, the same church that George Washington used to attend? And did you know that during that war, Lee's properties in Arlington were seized, and a portion of his estate was used to establish a freedmen's village around the location of the present-day Iwo Jima Memorial, and that the remainder of that estate became the Arlington National Cemetery? Did you know that the Custis Lee holdings of land in Arlington were quite extensive and even included a part of South Arlington that today we know as Barcroft? Did you know that after the war and until his death 5 years later, Robert E. Lee served as the president of what was then called Washington College in Lexington, Virginia? Perhaps you did. But did you know that what is today the most competitive college in the Commonwealth and the ninth oldest in the nation, was on the verge of bankruptcy when Lee assumed the presidency. Did you know that after the war, despite commanding the Army of Northern Virginia, whose battle flag has been confused with the flag of the Confederate States of America, many companies across America and in the North as well as the South sought Lee because of his great talent, honor, character, and leadership. Did you know that it was only Lee who expressed great reluctance to associate his name with any of these institutions, considering the lost cause for which he had served as a supreme commander in the military? Did you know that as president of present-day Washington and Lee University, Lee grew that bankrupted college into a national college, began one of the first business schools and journalism schools in America, and instituted a student-administered honor system that is still in place today? Did you know that Lee told his students that at that college there was only one rule, that all students would behave themselves as gentlemen, and that in accordance with that code of honor, Lee stood against the student body and many influential town leaders when an attempt to establish a school for newly freed slaves was opposed by almost everyone, and that that school survived only because of the man today that we often associate with being a champion of slavery. Did you know that today that 95% of the graduates of that college are employed within 6 months after graduation? Over 90% of its pre-med and pre-law students are accepted to medical school and law school. That its graduates at mid-career earn more than any graduates of any other liberal arts college, and that that college is in the top 25 in the nation for females pursuing STEM degrees, which lead to the highest paying professions in the country. Did you know that Waleed Saeed, the organizer of the petition to change the name of the Waleed High School, and hashtag all of us, are not even in or from Arlington, Virginia? Waleed is a professional academic in Philadelphia and contributor to The Nation as well as the Islamic Monthly. He has organized similar petitions around the country, exploiting the death of the paralegal and the police officers in Charlottesville. And Monique O'Grady, as well as the Arlington County Democrats, would rather make this their winning issue in 2017 than to address the persistent achievement gap that has been present since Reconstruction in 1868, when persons of color were permitted to enter public schools. They have blocked proposals to invite public charter schools that might aid in eliminating the achievement gap, as they have done in other parts of the country, as determined by the 15 surveys that have been completed on public charter schools to date. And in a campaign of deceit and deception, they have joined leagues with the ACLU of Virginia, Democrat Underground, and the liberals in the Arlington County Republican Party to engage in a slanderous campaign against the only unabashed conservative in the race and a candidate whose entire life has touched upon education, from aiding in the instruction in the Sunday schools of his father's church to recruiting for his most prestigious alma mater today. Did you know that one candidate for Arlington County Public School Board not only attended General Lee's College in the Shenandoah, but was also the first African American ever to be elected to student body office at that liberal arts institution, and that he also used to drink beers with the great-great-grandson of Robert E. Lee himself? But don't tell his preacher daddy, because Baptists really aren't supposed to drink alcohol. And now, he wants his new home of Arlington to have only the best, too. Honest.
My name is Major Mike Webb, and I earned my majority as an Army Ranger, where Rangers lead the way. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Just imagine.
This advertisement was authorized by Mike Webb.
Honest.